Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and today I'm joined by my good friend Carlos.
What's going on everyone?
For those of you who are new to the channel, Carlos has a channel called Brooklyn Fragrance Lover. I'm going to be leaving his information down below. And today we're going to be taking a closer look at a fragrance by the company Arabian Oud, and this one is called Solid, so make sure to stay tuned. Before I begin the video, I do want to mention that my friend Carlos and I, along with a few other YouTubers and Instagrammers, recently attended an event at the Arabian Oud store. Every single person there got a gift bag. This happened to be in the gift bag. The review was not an obligatory gesture, but it's something that I want to do because I genuinely enjoy the fragrance. I also want to say before we begin talking about the fragrance, if you are new to this channel, I would love it if you could support this channel by clicking the red subscribe button in the corner, but please wait until the end of the video to do so, so that we can provide value first. How's everything going, Carlos?
Not bad. Day off. Nice. Day one of three. So
nice. Okay, cool. Good stuff. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
So thank you for making the trek all the way to New Jersey. I know it's a long journey, but I always appreciate having you and Mikasa. So today we're going to be taking a closer look at a fragrance by the company Arabian Oud. Like I said earlier, this one is called Solid, and I think it's a solid fragrance. No pun intended.
Can I say something?
Yes, please.
Solid, solid as a rock. Comment down below if you know that song. He doesn't know that song.
Before
I'm showing my
age. I've heard it before, but I can't say it's one that I actually know the lyrics to.
Okay.
So that's awesome though. So this one is a vanilla based scent, and it's totally not what I was expecting just from looking at the bottle and reading up the notes online, because there's rose, there's musk, there's orange blossom. So it was really, it seemed in my mind to go in a different direction. I came home, I sprayed it on, and by the way, let me show you the cool mechanism they have here. So the top portion swings open like this, and there's actually a separate little box. I don't even know where I put it at this point, but it actually comes in a little box, and distribution on this one is really nice, and I personally think this smells awesome. So
that's something just to booby trap Carlos, because I don't do well with these mechanism thingies, majiggies, whatever.
I know. It's kind of like the monk house. You have to take the pinstripe.
Smells
off.
So good. This is a good one.
Okay, so Carlos off camera said it kind of reminds him of a creamsicle, and I completely agree. The strongest note that you're going to get in this one is vanilla through and through. Perhaps there's a little bit of an accent from the orange blossom, kind of reminding you of like an orange creamsicle, but not entirely. What do you think of the smell?
It reminds me of a creamsicle, which is the orange on the outside with the white in the middle.
Exactly, yeah.
I don't think the floral component of the orange blossom is very forward. The vanilla is front and forward and the featured player in this fragrance for sure. It's not overly syrupy vanilla. It's not cloying. It's a nice grown-up vanilla that's enjoyable.
Uh-huh. So I actually have a 10-fold distillation of vanilla. It smells very similar to Spiritu Double Vanille. Imagine reducing the opacity of Spiritu Double Vanille by Guerlain by like 50%. That's pretty much what you're going to get here. Not to say that it smells similar to the Guerlain. I really don't think it does. The Guerlain has a lot more complexity. This one is a bit more simple, a bit more linear, but it's still enjoyable at the end of the day. So you don't really get the other elements in this fragrance, right? Like the rose and the
no,
musk in the woods.
No, it's the orange blossom and vanilla. Yeah. Basically, and whatever kind of woody component is in there.
Yeah.
In the dry down.
Very, very faint. So
yeah.
I wore this one last week, and I got about 5 hours longevity from this one. And I think the takeaway from this one is that it doesn't have that many volatile notes in it. So you're not going to expect it to really boom and burst off your skin. This one is kind of quiet. So I think that that's a fair criticism to give to this fragrance. If only it were for some more loud and volatile ingredients in the opening, I think it could have performed a lot better in the projection department. But the longevity is pretty decent for 5 hours.
The fragrances from this brand really do project from skin. I got to tell you, all the ones that I've worn, I'm about to review a few myself, and they project nicely from skin.
Yeah. Yeah, so that was one of my, that's one of the things that I love personally, because I also own Cashmere by this brand. The longevity and the projection on that one is crazy. If you spray it on clothes, you got to wash that shirt like 2 or 3 times to get it all fully. This one is a bit on the quiet side, but it's such a heavenly smell, and there's something almost like slightly boozy about it, but not entirely so. I would say that the ratio of ingredients is like 80% vanilla, 20% orange blossom. Would you agree?
Yes. And it reminds me also, I can't think of the name. I own it and I'm such an airhead. It's so annoying sometimes, Carlos.
A vanilla scent?
It's an orange blossom, myrrh, and vanilla scent from Killian.
Oh,
it's discontinued. It's retired, this particular fragrance, but it reminds me of that.
It's not Cruel Intentions.
It is not. It's, okay. That's a good one.
Yeah.
But it's not. I can't remember. I'll find it and you'll, Yes, that's the one. Thank you very much.
I was thinking, I wore like, it to the event. It has to be Love or Sweet Redemption. So, okay, sweet. Yeah, that's a really good one, too. It's a shame that a lot of these really good fragrances get discontinued, but...
It's annoying.
I know. So that's the longevity on this one. The presentation for this one, I think, is awesome. In terms of my favorite Arabian Oud perfumes, and there's a lot. So this brand has 177 that they've released to date. And I think the more accurate number is like 183 because they actually came out with 5 new ones.
That's a lot of Arabian Ouds.
I know. And they came out in 2012.
Whoa.
Yeah. So they produced a lot of fragrances in a short period.
They're in a lot of countries. I believe 71 countries. If I correctly.
Mm-hmm. So this is one that I personally enjoy. I think you can pull this off in the summertime, but I would prefer to wait until the fall. Perhaps because of the performance, I wouldn't wear this one in the winter because I don't think it's as strong. That's when I would reach for something like Desert Falcon, which is another one I don't own. But if I owned it, I would reach for that. I would also reach for Cashmere.
We have thousands of fragrance around this, but we still need others. They're still on the to-buy list.
I know. That's how we are. All the time. So
I still smell it.
It's amazing. Well, I have the test strip here.
I got a whiff from down there.
So good. Oh my
God. What happened to the other enclosure?
Okay, so let me get it.
The toaster. Sorry.
We didn't put it on camera because we thought it looked like a toaster.
But I did. He didn't.
So it looks like this. It says solid. And you open it up and the bottle rests in there.
That's another feature about this company, that they really do put a lot of emphasis on their presentations.
Agreed.
They even have matching bags for each fragrance.
That is so insane. And there's a metal plaque on the bag.
Mm-hmm.
So the same way you'll find a metal plaque like on the presentation, they also include it on the bag. So you can tell this company has money. They're able to do a lot of really wonderful things. And I personally think that this is a really wonderful scent. So... thank you all at home so much for tuning in. And Carlos, thank you so much for being on my channel.
My pleasure, buddy. Anytime.
Let's go ahead and shoot some more videos before you have to leave. So once again, if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video, I would really love and appreciate if you could support what I do and what I have been doing for the past 7+ years. It's easy and it's free, I assure you. All you need to do is click that red subscribe button in the corner. So this way, whenever I do upload future fragrance-related content, it will get delivered straight to your feed. You never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. And also make sure to click that bell notification, and so you can be rest assured that you'll get this notification. Once again, Carlos's information is going to be down below. Definitely make sure to check him out.
Come say hello.
Great content at his channel and some really interesting reviews coming out. Take my word for it. Thanks again for watching. Love you guys, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Take care.
Bye.